Hi, this is Gary with MacMost.com. Today, let me show you how to create the double exposure effect on your Mac without using Photoshop or really any graphics app at all. MacMost is brought to you thanks to a great group of more than 600 supporters. Go to MacMost.com/Patreon. There you could read more about the Patreon campaign, join us, and get exclusive content and course discounts. So the double exposure effect is when you combine two images, one on top of the other, and kind of blend them together. But it's a little more than that. You only want the combination to happen in a certain area of the photo. Now usually people use Photoshop or some other graphics app to create that. But you could actually do it just using Keynote on your Mac. The result isn't perfect, but it's pretty easy for anybody to do. So in your Keynote, we're going to start with the basic black template. I'm going to remove the text that's in there, and I'm going to change the size of the document to something different than just the standard widescreen. I'm actually going to set it to exactly the size of the image. So looking at the image, I could see it's this particular size right here. Your image, of course, is going to be different. But the idea is now I've got a slide that's that exact size. Let me shrink it down a little. I'm going to use Command Shift and then less than. So now I could see the entire slide and a little bit of the area around it. Now I'm going to drag and drop that image from the Finder into the slide. And you can see it appears here. Now this type of effect works best when you've got a subject like this that's well separated from the background. So you see a nice uniform background here and there's the subject. So you can't just start with any image. But we'll look at this one and we'll look at another example in a bit. So the first thing we want to do is we want to prepare this image so it can be combined with another. Now I want the combination to happen over the head here. I don't want it to happen here over the background. To do that, I'm going to go to Format and then Image. This is with that image selected. And then use Instant Alpha. Now you may have already used Instant Alpha for something else. And you may already know you can click on something like the background here and drag a little bit to select the entire background but not too much. We're not actually going to do that here. I'm going to hit the Reset button at the bottom. We're actually going to do the opposite. I want to select the woman here, not the background. That's a little tougher. So if I click somewhere in her skin and drag away a little bit, you can see it selects more and more of her, but eventually it selects the background. I'm going to back off when I do that and not select the background at all. So you can see it only selects a portion of her. Well, you can keep clicking and then dragging to select more of her. So I can do that each time, making sure I back off before I select any of the background. So I'll do that with her hair here. I'll do it with a little bit more of her hair. And I'll keep going until I've selected enough of her. It doesn't have to be perfect as long as I don't get any of the background. It's going to take several different attempts here to keep grabbing more and more until eventually I have enough. Doesn't have to be everything, but the more you get, the better the effect will look. So you can see here I've grabbed quite a bit and I'm going to hit done. And what's going to happen is everything I've selected is now going to be cut out. So the black you're seeing here is actually the black background showing through. So now we can bring in another image. I'm going to bring in the image of a sunset and I'm going to drag that in. Now this is going to be a smaller image than the previous one. So I'm going to expand it a bit, make sure it covers the area very well. And then I'm going to send it behind the first image. So I'm going to go to Arrange and Send Backward or Send to Back. Send Backward, Send to Back one step, which is all I need now. So now you can see how it appears behind her. At this point I can see there are pieces of her hair that I missed. I can click here on the background to select that image and I can go into Instant Alpha and I can continue to grab more areas. So I can make this even better. Then I'll hit Done. So now I've got most of it. You can get a little bit more detailed when you work. So now you can see here that I've got the front image and it's got a big hole in it and the back image is showing through. This isn't really what we want. We want to combine the images. We don't just want to have a cutout with another image shown in it. So to combine them, you would do something completely different if you were using a graphics app. But here in Keynote, the trick is going to be to select that original image. I'm going to copy and paste it. So I'm creating a duplicate of it. I could also have used duplicate selection or just option and dragged. So now I have a second copy of the cutout.
what I'm going to do is I'm going to leave that right there over everything. But I'm going to go to Instant Alpha and I'm going to hit Reset. So that goes back to the original version of that. Now I'm going to hit Done and I'm going to go to Style and look for Opacity. And here I'm going to make it semi-transparent. And as I do, it's going to reveal the image behind it. So I have three layers here. I've got the regular image but semi-transparent here with opacity set to something less than 100. Then I've got the image but with the head cut out. And then behind that I have the image of the sunset so it shows through. Now I could drag the sunset image to position it exactly where I want and I could scale that. Sometimes it could be hard to grab an image that's between other ones. But in this case, since the sunset image is going to be scaled larger, I have all this area around it to grab. So I can go ahead and scale it and set it to the position I want. I can click to select the front image there and set the opaqueness so I can basically have it be half an image of her and half an image of the sunset with the area out here, the background, actually being completely just 100% the background. It's a semi-transparent version of the background over a completely opaque version of the background. So it combines to just be the background. If this weren't yellow, if this were something else, like you know other people and other things going on behind her, you would still see that as 100%. You would only see the sunset coming through here with her. You can easily replace this background here. Let's drag a skyline, for instance. Put that back there. Then I'm going to arrange, send it to the back. And you can see how it shows through there. I'm going to want to scale this quite a bit and set it up like that. So now you've got that there as the background. And that may require a different, you know, opacity for the head there depending upon how strong that background image is. Now as another example, let's go and get rid of the woman there and go with this background here as the main image that we're going to use. So I'm going to scale that up. Normally I would have made the keynote slide the exact size of this. And now I'm going to cut out the skyline here. So I'm going to go to Image, Instant Alpha, and then I'm going to select the buildings. And it's not going to be perfect. I want to back off as soon as I see it start to select something else like the water like that. So go to about right there and then see what it is I've missed. So here's part of that building there. There's the top of this tower here. And I want to think whether I want these sails to be in it or not. And now here's a trick. Not only can you click and drag to select things, but you can shift click and drag to deselect them. So I can deselect this sailboat here by shift clicking and dragging in it so I can get the sailboat back into the picture. You can also, of course, use Command Z to undo, which is very useful when you're working with this. So I'll get this image where I want it to and hit Done. So now I've cut out the city skyline there. Let's bring something else in here. I'm going to bring in a background of some trees. And I'm going to set this up to be behind the city. Let's go and arrange and send it to the back. So now you can see the trees showing through the buildings. Let's go and select the buildings again. I'm going to copy and paste. Or let's just do the duplicate selection there. And I'm going to Instant Alpha Reset. So this one at the front is just the original photo of the skyline. But I'm going to go to Format, Style, Opacity and set it to be semi-transparent. So now I've got the trees showing through on the building. I can match the bottom of the trees right there with the water. Maybe scale it up a bit like that. So now I've got the trees and the buildings on top of the trees. Combining those two ideas. And notice the sailboat is in front of them all because I subtracted that from the alpha. So it's not being replaced by the trees in either layer. So now that I've got that, how do you then export this? Well, you go to File, Export To, and then you do Images. And you can export it in a format. Let's do JPEG High Quality. You can go PNG if you want top quality. And export this out. And it creates a little folder there with the name of the keynote in it. But in there is your image. And you can take a look at that. And it's just a regular JPEG image that now you can use.
So it's a lot of fun to play with. And as I said before, you know, pros will do this using Photoshop or some other image editing app. But if you want to create the simple effect without investing in new software, or you find this process a little bit easier since you already know Keynote, then it allows you to do basically the same thing. Although if you want to use more effects and get even more detailed, then it kind of becomes necessary to move on to software like Photoshop. I publish new tutorials every weekday. Hit the subscribe button so you don't miss out. Then hit the little bell icon to get notifications for each new tutorial.